Adding mods to Automobilista 2 doesn't take longer than a couple of minutes nowadays. How, I hear you ask? Find out right here, right now. Greetings, Romies, and welcome to RomRom, the channel sharing the joy of sim racing and to Simple Tips, our guide to sim racing. Welcome to the channel if you're new here, and thanks to all those who come here often, especially those who subscribe. My name is Serta, and I will be your host for this video. Right until shortly, adding mods to Automobilista 2 was a complex issue that involved a lot of toing and froing with files, editing text files and whatnot. Well, no more. While by far not as polished yet as the Assetto Corsa content manager, Automobilista 2 drivers now have a quite easy way to add mods to Reiza's sim. Depending on if you already installed mods on Automobilista 2 using the old method or not, there's a couple of things you have to do before using the Automobilista 2 Content Manager. If this is your first encounter with mods in Automobilista 2 and you never installed any, feel free to jump to the timecode shown on the video or the respective chapter Starting Automobilista 2 Content Manager. But should you have installed mods on Automobilista 2 using the old and dusty JSGME, you will need to deinstall your mods and the boot files. Start JSGME one last time and move any files you have to the right in Activated Mods, to the left in Available Mods. Kiss JSGME goodbye, thank it for its good service, and close it. You won't ever need it again. Another thing that belongs to the past are the boot files. Oh yeah, history baby, forever history. Alright, we expect you to have installed Automobilista 2 Content Manager wherever it fits you better, which is an incredibly easy thing to do. One thing about the installer, if you're a member of Reiza's Paddock Club, you will be able to install mods also on the beta versions of Automobilista 2. But you have to tell Automobilista 2 Content Manager during installation, or it will ignore any installed beta version of Automobilista 2. If, on the other hand, you tell it to search for the beta, you'll find a second icon on your desktop called AMS2 Beta CM. Automobilista 2 Content Manager needs the .NET 6 desktop runtime to run, but don't worry, it checks automatically for it and will prompt to install it. This being the first time you are using it, Automobilista 2 Content Manager will look like this. Don't worry, you have done nothing wrong. While in our opinion it's a strange graphic user interface, it's the way the software starts when there's nothing installed. Open up whatever folder you have for your downloaded Automobilista 2 mods, drag and drop any archives you want to add to Automobilista 2 into Automobilista 2 Content Manager. Normally, mod makers have done everything right, but if Automobilista 2 Content Manager has issues with any archive, it may well be that the mod maker or makers put an archive inside an archive. You will have to open the archive then and put the second archive into Automobilista 2 Content Manager. A small hassle, but as word of the Automobilista 2 Content Manager is spreading around, and rightfully so, more mod makers are making it easier to install their mods. If you would like to help us bring you better product reviews and sim racing news in the future, you can do so by becoming a patron at patreon.com/romrom. Amongst other perks, becoming a patron will fix your name for posterity like this, but you'll also be able to participate in our podcast recording, get to know what we plan and what we're doing, and we'll be able to take part in our decisions. So, a big thank you to our patrons and members. If you come here often, please consider subscribing. And that's it! Anything you dropped into Automobilista 2 Content Manager should be already available on Automobilista 2 after you press the Apply button. Note that Automobilista 2 has to be closed while adding new mods, or else Automobilista 2 Content Manager won't add any mods. and it could lead to issues with Automobilista too. By the way, you can also drop liveries, driver liveries and everything else you can change within Automobilista 2 into Automobilista 2 Content Manager. If the archive is well built and has all needed folders in it, Automobilista 2 Content Manager will recognize what it is and put it in the right place. Within Automobilista 2 Content Manager, you can activate and deactivate any mods you want, group, deactivate, etc. Just don't forget to press apply once you're happy with your choice. All key combinations you know from Microsoft Windows to handle files are usable here, including Ctrl A to select all files. If at some point you want to completely delete a mod from the Automobilista 2 Content Manager list, just mark it and press the delete key. Automobilista 2 Content Manager has a Discord server with the list of possible issues and their solution, and you can, of course, chat with other users and the developer. The developer is in contact with the Automobilista 2 developers, and hopefully this will be a growing and thriving partnership to make it enormously easy to expand the joy of sim racing within Automobilista 2.